As a matter of fact, we got on one of the hosts of one of the shows on the Two Live Stews Radio Network, John Fisher. His show, Cooking with the Microwave, comes on the Two Live Stews Radio Network a couple days a week. But John Fisher, how many years, how long have athletes been wearing gold chains under their uniform in sports? Not just in football, but in every sport. Forever guys been wearing chains. Who the fuck does Talib think he is?
Hey, he don't like Crabtree. They both from Dallas, man. They got some type of history. They've known each other since they were kids.
Right.
So they got some type of history. And if you notice, Aqib Talib is apparently not the only corner that doesn't like him. Remember, him and Richard Sherman had words, and Richard Sherman don't like him. So I don't know, for whatever reason, they know each other back from Dallas area. And it got to the point to where Talib was just like, every time I see him, I'm going to yank his chain off.
Right. Who the hell is he think he is?
He think he Debo, and he should have did like Red and tuck his in.
Right.
He had a turtleneck on, tuck it in.
Right.
Hey, I'm going, bro.
Hey, appreciate the call. That's my man John Fisher cooking with the microwave. Who the fuck does Talib think he is? This man think he a combination of freaking, I don't know, Debo. As John Fisher just said, Debo and the freaking Goose from Different Strokes. Right, this man think he the Goose from Different Strokes. I'm a grown-ass man. You don't snatch my damn chain off. And the point I was making to Fish is very true. Cats been wearing jewelry under their uniform since I can remember. What do you mean you don't like it that he wears a chain under his damn shoulder pads? Man, the hell with you. I actually applaud Crabtree, man. Damn Talib. Hey, back in 3 minutes. Hour number two of the Doug Stewart Show. Don't go away.
Came and get it drunk with a dame or shit it drunk. You came and get it on. More than 5 O's in your bank to get it on. Roll up like that plank and get it on. Plank to fit it on. Came to get it on. Hold up, you wanna work that, twerk that. Let me in, let me hurt that, murk that. Say you gotta hurt back. Can't spit it out, boo, you gotta slurp that. Can't cut it after we done, it wasn't worth that. So we ain't responsible for bringing dirt back. Back up. She has the bar style and she's throwing it up. She drank a little Hypno, throwing it up. But I'm only dealing with freaks that wanna cut mine. If you agree, it won't nut. Can't try to get it played late night on BT Uncut. Fellas,
do your thing, let me do my thing.
I mean,
do your thing, let me do my thing. Move that thing, mommy, move that thing.
Come on,
move that thing, mommy, move that thing.
Huh.
So do your thing, let me do my
please
thing.
Tell it,
bump, 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 bump it out.
I see some haters grilling. I see some ladies chilling. I see that girly I've been plotting to get. You got hop in the whip and we come.
Bump, bump, bump it out.
Okay, we was leaving, we was done. Then she said, can my people come? Here we go, I see you, don't stop. They wanna ride in something with a rim, don't stop. Look, baby, you fine, but your girlfriend's not. And as you wanna hold out, getting cute on the phone, I ain't gotta be bothered, be cute on your own. My jump off, baby, run up with the macro, man. My jump off, baby, that's why I
come out. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Who the fuck does Talib think he is, man? Hey, the number to the show is 404-822-5467. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. For you greenhorns listening to the show right now, I think we could probably put Joe Budden in the one-hit wonder category, because I don't remember any other track that he's had other than this one. But Joe Budden got a little bit of history, man. And not only is he very critical and keeps it real about mumble rappers. Not only does he keep it real on mumble rappers, y'all seen the interview that he did, him and the other dude, I don't know, who does a little YouTube show. The little interview that they did with Lil Yachty? Yeah. Yeah. He straight clown Lil Yachty. Which I totally understand. Hey, welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Man, we got so much. We got so much shit to get to today, man, and not enough time to do it. The number to the show is 404-822-5467. You can also email me at Doug, thedougstewartshow.com. From Sluggo in the chat room on Spreaker.com. Crabtree is probably scared of Tlaib. Tlaib better cut that shit out. I agree. Now, I don't know. I think when they first, this little thing started last year, I think that, and even before, you remember Tlaib's been shot a couple of times, something like that. Like, I believe the story is that he might be gang affiliated or whatever. But hey, man, I mean, sometimes, you know, enough is enough. And like most of y'all, you probably dealt with a bully in your life. And there comes a point where a dude is just fucking with you so much, you just got to go ahead and just suck it up and fight the dude. You may not even think that you're going to win. You might even think you're going to get your ass kicked. But you know if you don't do something, it's going to continue. And, I mean, I keep talking about how much shit was probably talked to Crabtree. And this is crazy because he's a grown-ass man. It's not like they're kids on a playground. But it's crazy how, you know, juvenile and caveman-ish that dudes are. And the same shit that you was doing when you were 7 and 8, the same issues that you had as a young boy, you somewhat have the same issues in a slightly different form as an adult. And there was just no way around it. Like, pretty much Crabtree probably in his mind said that if this dude look at me wrong, it's on and popping. I got to get me some get back. So I totally respect that, man, from Sandman. Hell no. I'm not going to just stop wearing my chain because a nigga snatched my chain on the field. Snatch it and we fighting. Right. Right. And I'm not buying, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. We're brought to you by DougieDeals.com. I'm not buying, and I love Jay Fish, but I'm not buying this whole thing about what happened to play before. So you mean to tell me, because Crabtree and one of Tlaib's teammates have an altercation, Tlaib takes as an opportunity to snatch this damn man's chain off again for 2 years in a row? Hell no. What that tells me is he was looking for a reason to start some shit again. That's what that tells me. So damn it, if you want to start some shit again, we're going to just go at it. How about that? How dare you grab that man's chain off? Like, that's unbelievable. Now, and I don't think, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, I don't think the NFL has actually come out with the penalty for these guys yet. But we're going to keep our eye on the ticker to see if they do. But, man, I'm telling you, Tlaib is a freaking menace. He is a freaking menace to society. If I'm the NFL, I'm suspending that ninja for 5-6 games at the least, because damn it, he's got a record. He's a habitual line stepper. I don't like no shit like that. One thing I don't like, I don't like no damn bully. I don't like no damn bully, man. You know? And so, as I said, man, I actually feel Crabtree, man, having to step to that guy. Like, it was more about football, and Crabtree probably knew he was going to get suspended. He probably knew that he was going to get fined. He probably knew he was going to get kicked out of the game and all like that. But sometimes, man, some shit is just more important than others. Like, this was so important to him to him as a man, you know, that he had to do what he had to do. And I totally get it. From Fail Pay says, Crabtree swinging on a cat with a helmet and Tlaib backing up away from the punch. Laugh out loud, I would have headbutted his fist. Yeah, you're not even thinking when you're in a situation like that, man. From what do we have here? Sluggo. Tlaib out there thugging. Didn't one of them Denver boys send rounds his way? He better cut that ish out. Ninjas don't fight no more. Very true. Very true. I just don't like that type of shit, man. From ex-mayor Mochi, the Laker fam. Tlaib didn't instigate the fight on this particular occasion, so why he getting 5 games, Doug? What do you mean he didn't instigate the fight? You didn't see the video? He snatched the chain off of Crabtree again. Crabtree was blocking him. Crabtree was blocking him. Had him engaged. They were engaged. Crabtree was blocking the guy. And when he was engaged with the block, Tlaib pulled the guy's chain off again. And I guess all at the same time, Crabtree realized that this ninja pulled my chain off again. and continued to dry block his ass to the sideline, pushing him into 50, 11 different people into the ground. Yeah, that's where it started. I don't know. Are you getting a different take on what happened? There's no different take on what happened. Dude snatched his chain off again. Rail Scott says, a ninja snatched my shark hat back in 85. What the hell is a shark hat? Is that something popular up there in Philly, Rail? He says, a ninja snatched my shark hat back in 85 and my feelings was hurt. You get your chain snatched, ninja. That's personal. That's beyond personal. Like, it's man law. It's man law that you got to come back at that dude. Like I said, I believe in my heart of hearts that Crabtree had already made his mind up that he was going to go after this dude in this game. He had to get some get back, and I totally get it. So I ain't never got anything stolen from me, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. And if you're a young dude, man, I came up in the era where things were snatched all the time. Okay? You know? And this was kind of like during the time in between where dudes were still fighting a little bit, but then they started shooting people around the ladies or whatever. Okay? So we were kind of in that in between that stage. Now, if somebody snatches somebody, chances are they're going to get shot. But yeah, so I came up during the time when I was growing up in the low country of South Carolina, there was this big, big thing with these glasses, and they used to call them Malcolm X's. It's the same frames that Malcolm X used to wear, but they were gold. They were gold frames. And so they used to call them X's or Malcolms or whatever. And, oh, my gosh, ninjas were stealing them and losing their life over them damn glasses left and right back in 85, 86, 87 or whatever, man. That happened. That was big. If you remember, people my age, you remember the starter jackets. Dudes were losing their lives over starter jackets. You remember even before that. I can't remember exactly. Even before that. You remember the members-only jackets? You know, the little jackets with the little tassel on the collar or whatever, man. Like, cats were getting jacked for that. Don't talk about bombers or sheepskins, shit like that, man. And then the coup de grace of shit to get snatched. It was gold chains. They even made a damn movie out of it. Remember, I'm gonna get you, sucker? That was all about gold chains and cats stealing gold chains. So you had that. Dudes were stealing Jordans. So this is nothing new. But it's just the principle of the matter. On national TV, you going to snatch my damn jewelry off? Like, really? Like, it's still shocking to me that Tlaib did that last year on national TV. And then, so, think about it now. A year later, and this man thinks so much of you, Tlaib thinks so much of you as a man that he does it again? Nigga, you can, like I wouldn't have been mad if Crabtree would have went Last Boy Scout on his ass. You know what I'm talking about? You remember Last Boy Scout when the dude at the beginning of the movie pulled out a gun out of his damn pants and shot the other dude at the beginning of that damn movie? Like, I wouldn't have been surprised. I really wouldn't have been mad if he would have resulted in some crazy shit like that. You can't do that. Hey, man. My old man used to say it all the time. The last thing, the only thing that we got, especially as black men, is our respect. Period. Period. And evidently Crabtree had heard that before, man. He just wasn't having it. I totally get it. All right, when we get back from the break, man, let's get back into the football talk. 404-822-5467. Man Talk Monday. Weekend after Thanksgiving, man. Once again, hope you had a great Thanksgiving. A lot of stuff we got to still get into. Entertainment coming up here in a second. Stay tuned for that. The Power Hour coming up. College football. Wait, it's a ton we got to get to. Don't go away. The Doug Stewart Show.
Hello, everyone. This is Grandma Eunice. I want all of you to come on and listen to my grandson on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Help me keep this boy out of trouble. Come on, cook with the microwave on Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Grandma Eunice, bye-bye.